This is a demonstration of how to do the two calibration procedures required for the electronic vibration analyzer sensors. And so we've got a sensor right here, and this sensor, I've got it attached to a magnet that comes with the kit. Let me take that magnet off. Just a couple of little screws here, nuts. Okay, so this sensor needs to be calibrated every time, or anytime you get a new sensor or use the sensor in a different, or with a different EVA, or the EVA has two different input ports, input A, input B. But if you can see on this sensor, I don't know if you can see it, can you zoom in on that? Can you see the word up on that sensor? The word up needs to be facing up when we balance propeller shafts in the vehicle, or drive shafts as some people call them. Other than that, the word up doesn't matter if it's up or down. I've used this tool for over 20 years and it works great up or down for just regular vibration diagnosis. But for balancing propeller shafts, it needs to know which side is up or down so that it can shine the timing light in the proper position for us to add weights in the form of hose clamps to the propeller shaft as a counterbalance. And so there are two calibrations for the sensor and the EVA that I'm going to take you through. The first one is just simply called the vibration sensor calibration, and you will do this anytime you use a new sensor, or if you get a message that says the accelerometer is not calibrated or accelerometer bad. And so I'm going to take you through the step-by-step procedures for that. I'll just get the magnet out of the way. Okay, so first we connect the vibration sensor to the EVA. So let's go back to the EVA here up to the top. We've got input A and input B. I normally go with input A, and so I'm just going to plug that in here in the top at input A. The EVA, when it's turned on, defaults to reading from input A, but if you had a second sensor, then if we zoom out to the keyboard here, there's an AB button right here where we could switch from input A to input B and read from two different sensors. You need to calibrate both of those sensors for the EVA. Okay, so it tells us connect the sensor to input A or B, so we put it in A. Place the vibration sensor with the word up side facing up on a flat stationary surface. So over here on our sensor, I've got the word up on top there. It's facing up, but just the tension of the cord makes the sensor not want to hold flat down onto the table. So I'm just going to take a tool, just a, like a nut driver here, nut driver handle, and hold that down flat to where it's flat on the stationary surface. Okay, then make sure your cartridge is installed in the bottom of the EVA, which ours is. Power up the EVA with a 12-volt power supply, which ours is already. And then it tells us from the main menu, select normal mode. So looking at the screen here, we've got the smart EVA main menu. We've got the automatic mode, the normal mode, and the smart strobe. We want to go with normal mode. So I'm going to, on the keyboard here, hit the down arrow once to go to normal mode, and then hit enter. Okay, now it says press the AB key to indicate which input the vibration sensor is plugged into. Right now on the screen we've got the letter A indicating that we're receiving input from the sensor connected to input A, so we'll just leave it there. But if we press the AB button, it would switch to the letter B and read from the other port. All right, the next step is to press the number one key on the keypad to initiate the sensor calibration procedure. And it tells us it's important, do not move the tool or the vibration sensor during any part of this calibration procedure. So to start the procedure, to initiate it, here on the keyboard, I'm just going to click the number one one time, click, and then the next step is to press the number 2 key 3 times. So here's number 2, 1, 2, 3, and follow any on-screen steps displayed. So it tells us to turn the accelerometer over and then press any key to continue. So remember, I told you that this needs to know which side is up. We just told it that that was up. So we're turning it over. Put the weight back on it to hold it down. I'm just going to hit enter. And there we go. Channel A offset equals 8B, hexadecimal code. Mills or thousandths of an inch per G-force is 29 on this sensor. And press any key to continue. Those numbers you don't really need to know or write down or know anything about, but the reason for this sensor calibration is, even though all these sensors have the same part number, each sensor is just slightly different, and so it has to be calibrated for its unique properties for use here on the EVA itself. Okay, so that takes 20 to 30 seconds is all, and it'll take us back to the live data screen when we press any key to continue. So I'm just going to hit exit. And here we are back at the live data screen. So that sensor calibration is one that you should do periodically. You should also do that before you do any propeller shaft balancing in the vehicle. Now there's another calibration procedure, and this one takes about 10 minutes to complete, and it's one you don't need to do very often, but anytime you get a brand new sensor or a different cartridge that you put in, this, it's called a phase shift calibration, needs to be completed. Okay, so to initiate the phase shift calibration, we'll hit the number 5 key one time, and then the number 2 key 3 times. 1, 2, 3. And then you can walk away for about 10 minutes. And when I did this practicing yesterday, it took about 9 minutes total to do this. But this, when it's done, we'll give you a screen telling you to press any key to continue. And while it's going through this phase shift calibration, the numbers that are here on the screen will change. That's absolutely normal. Don't unplug the power while you're doing this, or you'll have to start over. Don't bump anything. Just leave it alone and let it do its thing. And then we'll come back when it's finished. So we will pause here for a moment. Okay, it's been a little over 9 minutes, and we get the message: burning center frequency, low 39, high 59.5, medium 51.0. Press any key to continue. So I will just hit exit. And we are done with the phase shift calibration. So this has been a demonstration of the two calibrations that can be done on the electronic vibration analyzer.